Deck building is one of Yu-Gi-Oh's biggest challenges to a player. Knowing the format and what staples to play is key to winning in a competitive environment. However, I decided to take on one of Yu-Gi-Oh's biggest deck building challenges. Starting with just 3 structure decks and a bi-weekly budget of just $40, I can only obtain cards through sealed official products. I can't trade, order any singles, or sell the cards I obtain through packs. This is Sealed Only Dinos. Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Sealed Only. Last time, we finally pulled Double Evolution Pill, which means we never actually have to open Dual Overload ever again. This means we're actually able to focus on consistency cards like Animador and Archosaur, or we can focus on getting key extra deck pieces like Evelzar Lagia or Evelzar Dolka. So I'm not going to waste any time. Without further ado, let's get right into the opening. Since last week we got Double Evolution Pill, I've decided to move towards the next step, getting Animador and Archosaur. We've opened this before, so it really shouldn't come as a surprise to anyone, but we also are opening... I also got a display case of Maximum Gold Eldorado. I did the math, and since I spent $70 on this display case, that means that each of the boxes that come in it are about 14 bucks. So that means that in addition to the 10, I can open up one of these boxes. But if you're doing the math, since these were only 14 bucks each, that means we still have 12 bucks worth of budget left. So I've just rounded it out with 4 Power of the Elements packs. So I'm going to be starting with the Maximum Gold Eldorado. What we need out of Eldorado is still just the generic dino stuff of Evelzar, Lagia, and Dolka. But there's also things like Pot of Extravagance, IP Mascarena, a lot of stuff I'm forgetting since this product came out a couple years ago. There's also Access Code Talker, which is pretty nice. I've always liked the packaging of these. I think it's really nice and fancy. But I've always hated this. I hated this because you kind of have to like fold it to like not destroy the packs trying to get them out. So we have 4 packs of Eldorado. Getting right into it, we have a Constellar Ptolemy M7, a Guardian of the Golden Land, a Rocket Tracer. I actually love how this looks in gold. It's been a hot minute since I played Dragon Link, but it pops up every now and then and it makes me pretty happy because this card is still busted to this day. We have a Print Kids Rocket Ride, a Super Express Bullet Train, and for the other holo. Okay, this is actually playable. Oh, we have same. Oh, okay, a third summon limit. I think we had 2 of those. But hey, we got the alt art Eldritch. That's pretty nice. I'm a big fan of the golden boy himself. But moving on to the second pack. I am terrible at opening packs. We have a Multifaker. Skipped right to it on accident. A Alan Bershon. A Meow Meow Moo. We have a Juggernaut Lieb. A Gold Rare Soul Eating Overraptor. That's pretty nice. We have a Psyframe Lord Zeta. And a Weather Washer. 2 more packs of Eldorado for today. Moving on to the second to last pack of Eldorado. We have a Numeron Gate. A Driver. A 2 Alan Bershons in the same box? That's kind of crazy. The Weather Snowy Canvas. A Tanky that's not misprinted. Shoutouts. An Area. And a Dragon Maid. Moving on to the last pack of Eldorado. I really just want to see a Dolka or a Lagia. But I will take things like a Access Code or IP. We have a Doodle Doodle Doo. A Lampseas. A Breaksword. Is it all the way in the back? Wait. How do they organize these packs? That's not how it was the last couple packs. But yeah, we have a Breaksword. A Skystriker Ace Rose. And a Tempest Dragon Ruler of Storms. I totally forgot this was even in here. What a weird addition. Moving on to the packs of Pote. I'm really just looking for a starter in here or a jet. Nothing else in here really is crazy because we pulled both the secrets. This card is super annoying in a draft format, by the way. Okay, well, is that easy? Is that simple? It's a skill issue. You just got to say you want it and you get it. Jet's pretty good because now that we have that, it's another form of interruption going first or second, which is just super essential. But we have a Power Tool Braver Dragon. I still think this card is underrated. I think it's going to see play one day, just not right now, I guess. Second to last pack of Pote. We have a Gamma Burst, a Goaty Field Spell, a Sprite Smashers, which I'm pretty sure we already had, but it's nice to pull it again. A Hydralander Orbit, and a Ika, the Flame Buddy. And then we have some commons. Last pack of Pope. I'm not really expecting anything. We got the one thing we wanted, but a starter would be really nice. We have a Cross Keeper, a Vernisylph, an Amaze Attraction, a Life Extreme, and a Favorite Contact. That could have been the starter. So the last thing we have is the tin. This is pretty much the only thing we really need to open. So we have three huge, chunky, thick boys in the form of these 2021 tin of Ancient Battles Mega Packs. God, these are huge. I always forget how huge these are. Look at that thick pack. We have a Dark Templar, a Melfi Playhouse, a Goki Ironclaw, a Rosin Ryu, Dice Dice, an Uvaloop. For the first super, we have a Gizmek Okami, a Magical Hound, an El Shaddoll Apcolone, a Dragite, it's an effect monster, a Girsu. And then we have a bunch of commons. There is a common I'm looking for, but we didn't pull it. And the more we pull of that common, the more it, our deck is going to have a second engine. But it's a really unique, little thing. And I saw someone else doing it, and I want to do it for myself, but with dinos, because I think it would be really funny. But moving on, we have a AI's Ritual, a Melfi Mommy, Fury of Kairu Shin, Dark Lord Nurgle, a Feedran, a Red Rain, a Chaos Summoning Beast, a Titanocider, a Raviel, Lord of Phantasms, Shimmering Scraper. Always thought it was weird they put these cards in the tins. I'm not complaining, this card is pretty. We have a Dogmatica Fleur-de-Lis for our Ecclesia. That's actually huge, I forgot that we needed this. And we have a spell, Tactics. No shot, dude! So, while I play the TCG, I've only had that one Tactics because it's sealed only, and I didn't really buy more just because I didn't really want to. It was going up in price, and I didn't even get the reprint of it. I actually just... We have two Tactics. That's fucking huge. Oh my god, I don't know what to say about that, bro. That's our second Tactics? These tins are good, dude. We got two good ultras out of that one pack. They're not Anemdorned. We weren't looking for these, but we're gonna take them. But yeah, we have a Chuche, and we have some more commons, but not the common I'm looking for. Moving on to the very last pack of the tins. If we don't pull Amador today, it's not a big deal. This opening was a success. So yeah, moving on, we have IQ, a Cybers Accelerator, a Bellcat Fighter, a Rika Queen Strenna, a Buzzsaw Sark, a Jabbing Panda. For the first super, we have a Super Heavy Samurai Scarecrow. We have a second Lingaribo. We have a Machina Metal Cruncher, which is just a beautiful Prismatic Secret Rare. Seeing this in a beautiful Prismatic Secret Rare is just so gorgeous. Moving on to the actually important pulls, though, we have an Effect Monster in the Ultra slot. Is it Animadored? It's a Tri-Brigade Nerval. But next we have a Dogmatica Maximus. That's actually not the worst thing to pull. And for the rare and the commons, we didn't pull anything crazy, but we did pull another Blizzard, which is actually a pretty decent side deck tech. Overall, this was a pretty good opening just because of these two. Eldritch is neat. Smashers and Jet is neat, but these are the real MVPs. Like, God, just look at this card, dude. This card just says draw two on it. What's not to like?
So for the deck edit this week, we actually have some pretty big changes. The top row is what's going out, and the bottom row is what's going in. All of these are pretty big changes to the deck, but the only one I feel like I actually have to explain is Adamancipator Analyzer. I actually just found this in the sealed only bulk, and it's a level 4 tuner that can special itself if only our opponent controls a monster. This is pretty good because it pretty much facilitates Bagooska going second a lot more often. But for the side deck, we actually have a really simple change. I actually just took out 6 useless cards and put in 6 cards that actually do something. There's not much to actually say about these changes. They're all pretty self-explanatory. So let's just hop right into our matches. For today's matches, I met up with a few of my friends at one of the local card shops in my area to playtest. The first match of the day was against my friend Drew, who was on Melfi Sprite.
Harold?
Yes.
Are you ready for reasons?
No. Okay, yeah. I'll take first.
Yeah.
Misc effect?
Because I'm ready. When I tell you I'm ready.
I'll send Megalos Magic.
Again? Against Starlight. And Zayak too!
Summon UC2. Set 1.
Yeah. Well, is that really good? That's probably best. I think it's best deck right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's up there. There's not like
a best
deck.
Sure.
There's not a defined best deck in Edison.
No, you didn't go into it. Then on res?
UC2 effects.
But it's very close.
You need one?
It's basically an negate.
Sure. It's
really nice. Yeah. It tributes Dino's on field. It destroys Dino's from hand or people. On res. You see TFX?
Mm-hmm. Went to a tournament in last week. Didn't think it would be a lot of
cool.
No, I saw that chat. I saw that
one turn too late.
I hate that.
TFX on Beaver.
Even
on Beaver.
Because AI knows how to play Yu-Gi-Oh! It does.
It does.
I
can't kill him there without being.
It's like with Eclipse, but the secondary effect is your monsters can't change the battle positions.
Is it the monsters that's currently on the field?
No, it's just your monsters can't change the battle positions.
The OCG version
is so pass. I like it.
Special reward.
Normal. And then thank you. Terrors of the over target Acura and target red.
And this coming in set.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe.
That's pretty good. Also, do.
Yeah,
add Soling over Raptor. Add UCT. Special.
Is it like over? Comes over something right now? Well, it's
played
for
It's here. 30. 18. Puts you at 22. On summon?
Sure.
Baby effects.
I looked at the top.
How long is this?
Yeah.
Oh, this is gone. I'm sorry. It's two. It's two standbys.
They're 199.
Swing mill, 1,000?
Yeah.
So you're
not
doing
the thing where you hit into
it.
No, I'm
not going to do that.
Yeah,
it's only if I protect it and.
I go first.
Back here.
Yes.
I mean, I have to.
Start.
Yes.
I do like it when like I put my Ryko on guard, they go attack our face down and flip back.
Can you point to
this too? Attacking over.
Make a token that searches.
Mm-hmm.
I can't target that way.
Correct.
This is one of the tokens that we
had
last weekend.
Is that just on field? Or
it's just you can't target Marvel on the field except for the token. Get in here. This is pretty good. Overwrap to target the token. I protect the token in the last round.
Yeah.
Summon Megalos Smash on X.
Yes. Attack or defense?
Attack.
Attack.
Want to get a battle?
Hit. Hit the spring. So swing rate.
Main phase 2? Don't worry. I have
a wall build on it.
I'll set 1, and I will pass. In your draw phase. Dino Mist target red. Chain Zeus, or we get a resolve.
Yeah.
Everything else.
Oh, so I can't resolve
smashes. Yes.
Right.
Why didn't you just respond with red?
Red. Oh.
Oh, this is pain.
That is true.
Try to put in an intercept.
Okay.
I don't know.
It's okay.
I guess we're passing.
You passing?
Drop. Not particularly happy with that.
Yes.
Activate
Emit. No, I don't want to activate this. Normal Obi effect. Dumpster Ads.
Dumpster Ads.
Add special UCT.
Vanish.
Use 2. Activate Miss for 2. I guess it's just some baby. Battle? 2000? 35. Yeah.
I mean, I can see it.
The second match of the episode was against my good friend, Michael West. He's playing an updated version of the Suship deck that we both made a deck profile for. And if you want to check that out, there will be a link in the description to that deck profile.
Heavy Samurai?
I don't read.
Oh,
4. I rolled a 3 last night, and then someone would stick guys on me.
The first result on
Direct. It's not the worst. Also do?
Yeah, that's fine.
Add Obi.
It says no matter the
thing. Normal?
Yep.
Yeah. That's okay.
It's like saying nothing.
Yeah,
oh, God.
No matter the situation.
Megalo
Smasher
X.
Yeah, that's fine.
Lamb and
okay.
punk ass. Draw. It's consistent. I made Maguska.
Painful?
Yes. There may be two worthless cards under him, but he is Magusi.
Shit.
The goose can turn around.
Fuck you.
Oh, Gunky.
Specials on the revealing.
It specials reveals in ads, right? Or does it exist?
No, so this one, special it. So you special by revealing another Shari. Special summons, little special summons in the deck, and then XYZ, but it all resolves in hand.
Yeah.
Yeah. We good?
Yes. I like how it's like a bite taken out of it, Bob.
Oh yeah, it does look like that. On summon effect to draw and go attack directly, and chain two to step.
Enemy skill target?
Chain three on the board.
Oh, it does that during your main phase?
Yeah.
Does it do it during your battle phase?
It does it during your battle phase.
I should have just waited.
Yeah. So I'm just going to add that to hand.
Yeah. Do you want me to do read two ships? No.
You played against it all the time.
That doesn't mean I read them.
That's true. Very true. Normal summon?
No, you're good.
Special summon?
Yeah.
After the effect would be the top three of my deck, and if it's a Shari, I get to add your summon.
Yeah.
Special summon that.
Yeah. You get attacked twice, right?
I'm going to be able to on my XYZ here. This might be game.
I think it is game.
It's game. Wait a second.
Okay, yeah, that one's on me. Let's just go to the next game. I want to forget about it already.
Oh, okay. And if you close your
eyes.
Don't worry, Gekki. Please. Don't I get hit? Please don't do it. Oh, okay, I'm fine with that. That's fine.
I will get you.
Oh, okay. Here you go. Don't full combo me. Oh, it's gonna. You're gonna have.
I don't know if I will have full combo. It depends on what my next draw is. Special by revealing.
Yeah.
Drawn in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. No, it does not. It just can't be destroyed by a card effect.
Okay.
Normal OV.
Add a baby.
Baby, yeah.
Special?
Just for something else. Yeah.
Add?
Yeah.
Over? It's 15.
He doesn't die once with the type was.
Oh, okay. Good.
So,
yeah, that's cool.
I'll take that.
15 over?
That's fine. Effect of this, the burn it for 250.
Sure.
I will activate it to send a bonus ship from field to grave. Because you monster, I can special summon this and activate. This is an activated effective list. Sure. So. Or without a secret material.
Does he also
on summon an effective draw?
Some ability
to
sure.
No, I don't think so. Is it over?
Yeah.
Effect to just permanently negate its effects.
Yeah. I think that we could get
the pass.
Sure. Effective enchantress to add.
They're pretty good.
Right back to him. You
I like the sneak one.
Effective fateful adventure to add a monster.
Sure.
Discard.
Sure. Well, I
have
both of which
sure.
Are showing. He basically said how much credit do I want to see
this guy?
Mm-hmm. On just
and Ash. The lump.
Yep.
All the ground local.
Yeah, sure.
And then, like, to drink it back about right. Second.
Yeah, I'm just the best at putting in
through this.
Oh, like, inner
sleeve. Oh, sorry, 4K. Right.
Yeah, that's good.
Overall, the deck has been really consistent in making Baguska. It's also pretty consistently been able to get out UCT as well. That being said, I did kind of just play suboptimally this episode. I could have beat over the red with my Baguska versus Sprite in that game too, and actually reading Suship cards so I don't run into a negate on their main phase. Small things like that could just easily be optimized by playing more. But if you enjoy this video, be sure to let me know in the comments and share it with a friend. I work pretty hard on these and I make them monthly. So if you enjoy them, let me know. But as always, I'll see you guys in the next Sealed Only Dinos. See ya!